It's almost 4 o'clock. I've had an amazing night.
Morning, guys. Alexander Nilsson here, and I'm a fear facer. That means that I seek out the fears in the areas I want to develop in, and then I do them. Even though it's scary and sucks and it's just like playing shoot me now. But I do it because through experience I've come to realize that that's the one thing that has the highest return on investment. And now when I'm at this awakened state, it just keeps going. The momentum is there and the growth is just pew-hoo. As an example of this, right now what's happening here is that this is the third weekend in a row I'm away from my comfortable little apartment and just being introverted and alone and recharging my batteries. That has happened as a result of me pushing myself lately extremely much within the social area.
Hallelujah!
Questioning my introverted label, and it's starting to pay off. I'm more confident and comfortable in these social situations.
Jag är inte ens som tar kort utan jag filmar, så kan vi få ett trevligt hipp hipp hurra för Anton.
Han lever! Hipp hipp!
Hurra! 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 Hurra!
Helt jäkla underbart!
One area that I've been really wanting to face my fears in is to be able to dance and enjoy and have fun at the dance floor in a sober situation. This played out yesterday and it was quite awful, but bear with me, just to give you some context. I'm at Öland, the place where I grew up, and we have celebrated my dear friend. He turned 30 and he threw this amazing party. We've been sleeping at this amazing houses. Just eating a lot of great food, hanging out.
Just like a picture.
Playing volleyball.
Ska du vinna nu, Anton?
Det går bra.
Det går bra.
See me.
Enjoying life together.
You're gonna kill him, Kenton.
Yeah.
I'm not saying this has been free from social anxiety, because it has not. Me putting my true, full, transparent me out there with my old friends and new friends, that's scary.
Fick inte du alldeles
med? Nej.
That's a whole different chapter in itself. As I said, I've been wanting to practice dancing because it's one of those things I know I enjoy so much when I am able to enjoy it. But we get up in our own head. We overthink. When we are not confident in an area, we judge ourselves and we have this self-doubting thoughts. We talk ourselves down. Really, really shitty thoughts. We're our own worst bully. Alex, what are you doing? Oh, you can't dance. Did you see how they look at you? You're shitty, shitty, shitty. Just get out of the dance floor. That was what happened yesterday. First off, it took 2 or 3 hours before I even dared to enter the dance floor. So prior to that, when I was just scared about it, I just...
Bara gå in och äg. Gå in och äg.
Vad fan?
I just ate instead, and I used that as a escape route. Talking to people and eating way too much, but eventually it was like, no, Alex, you want to dance, go dance, go move on that dance floor. Do you see how much fun they're having over there? So I pushed myself to go do that. Around, and it's just like I said, these self-loathing, negative, shitty thoughts just bombarded me.
All in my head. people think you're a really bad dancer. Oh, you dance like shit. You can't move. You don't have any rhythm.
But I refused to leave. Well, I left and I came back. I left and I came back because I know, I trust the process so much that when I am able to let go, when I can stand in the fear and eventually be relaxed enough and execute, whether it is about dancing, whether it is about overcoming the social anxiety wall of approaching a person and talking to them, I can reap the fruit, the rewards of my efforts. Eventually it did come. And I started to let go. I laughed at my negative self-thoughts. That's not entirely true, but I stopped listening to them and I just started to relax, started to enjoy it. I just had so much fun there out there at the dance floor, and I for sure didn't want any rewards for the best dance, but I don't care about that.
I'm just gonna dance and have fun. Connect just said I won the award personally, world best. I just had so much fun, but it was such a push.
I did what I wanted to do and I enjoyed it, and once again my fear-facing efforts paid off, and I'm so proud for that. I'm so proud for that, and it puts this aura over this week in an even better way. Having fun with friends, eating great food and dancing more. Facing fears is the way to go, if you ask me. That's what I do, and that's what I invite you to do. And as always, since we're having a total brand new week ahead of us, a week of opportunities, I'm inviting you to take on a fear-facing challenge. Every day, try to do something scary. Start implementing this fear-facing routine. Pick something. Identify a fear each day. It doesn't matter if it's very big or tiny, but it should be something out of your comfort zone, and it should be something that scares you. And then go do that thing and feel proud for that. Feel the growth, because it will happen. And do that for 5 days, Monday through Friday. See that as your little week challenge. Now I'm gonna go back to the house and hang out with people that I met here, the people that I already know. I wish you a great week, and I wish you good luck on these adventures. Love to hear what you think about this. If you're gonna face some fears, if so, what kind of fears are you gonna be facing? My name is Alexander Nilsson. See you in the next one. Bye, guys. Or should I say, bye, fear facer.